Well, as you saw from the last upload, I got the fenders all sanded out. They are pretty nice. They're pretty flat. They're about as flat as I want them to be. Other than there are some low spots here and there that are going to have to be addressed. And obviously, we're going to have some major soaking. I mean, you can see all of the twill and whatnot. So, that's a big thickness of basically like a Kevlar weave, So, with that said, it is going to be fun. UV rays will make it soak. So, we're going to go ahead and get it in primer and we're going to simulate the UV rays with the infrared heat lamp with that I have, which is not a cheap lamp. It's something that I've accumulated over time. That way, I don't have problems down the road. So, we're going to go ahead and we will bake out all of the primer, all of the product, so that it has the actual process and time allotted to get all of the solvents from the material like it's supposed to do. We don't have to wait for it to dry and do it on its own. We can actually speed the process, which is nice. I used to work the production field, so it's something that I don't miss at all. I like doing this. This is fun. This is my hobby. I love doing this. This is the best hobby I've ever had. Really want to get this bumper done. So I think that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to sand this thing out. I want to make sure that when I'm priming a lot of parts generally. So if I'm mixing anything up, it's not for just a small little job. I hate doing that, a little spot here and then move on to the next panel and have to work that and then mix up more primer. There's always a waste in between those steps. So the best thing to do is to actually grab all of the parts, have them all prepped, all ready, and have them all sitting out at one time. So you spray all at once. It's like a machine. It's more like an assembly line. I mean, Henry Ford kind of set it in stone for us that it was easier if you just did everything in that process rather than doing it one at a time, which took forever. It just didn't make sense. You just do the same step 10 times in a row, and when that step is done on all of them, you move to the next step that needs to be done, and then you do it on all of them. They're all getting touched, they're all getting done at the same time, versus they'll all be just sitting there while you're working on just one.
Thank you.
tell you what, that was a lot of work. Wow. Got just about every freaking thing on it done. All the edges. Everything's been feathered. Everything's flat. You know, flat as I feel safe and comfortable with, at least. And yeah, I mean, you could probably already tell with my voice, it just sounds like coarse and hoarse or whatnot. It's because I don't even know why I was doing this without a respirator, and all of a sudden it hit me. Hey, dummy, put a respirator on. So I've been breathing this in the whole time. It is what it is. One of those things where I just wanted to get it done, and I was kind of just headstrong to do it. But everything is A-okay, because I am happy with the progress in just a couple days of just hitting this, which is really good to have all this done in 2 days' work. You know, it's sun's starting to go down. It's 8 o'clock at night. Well, it's not night. It's getting there, though. I like that, how the summer comes on, how the sun is always out. That is nice. But with that said, I'm tired. Another day of body work. That freaking bumper kicked my butt. A lot of work on that thing. I did not think that it was going to take a whole day. And now I'm really glad that I decided to do just a time lapse. I ended up having to drag an extension cord over and plug in my phone, set it here, and get you guys the shot that I could, because the phone died on the first time lapse. So I'm gonna have to edit that in, etc. and whatnot, but at least I didn't lose the camera position. So you probably won't even be able to tell until, obviously, now that I'm telling you, probably. So long day, long day. I'm super glad I got it done. Wow. The front end of this car is flat. It's nice. I love it. It's great. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed what you're watching. This upload is probably going to be a little bit boring because it's me just basically sanding a bumper and not getting to the fenders or anything else. Thought I was going to get further along, but again, guys, this is a trial and error process. It's not like anybody's ever had the experience of being able to do this, and other than Vermont Sport Car. So super humbled by it. This is pretty cool, but it's a lot of work. Having fun. At least I'm having fun. That's the great thing about it. I'm enjoying this process. So hope you guys are enjoying watching it. Try to bring you guys a good daily upload now, especially now that Tyler's here, and you know, Tyler's already, he's gone. He's out. He's got this car back here ready. And it's awesome. This is awesome. So with that said, I'm Bill Schneider. I'm rambling. This is Rumble Garage. Work on only cars with stars. Subaru only. Have a good day.